It's important for me to win, you know, full stop, and for the team. I just want to win, and the team wants to win. That's what we're all working towards. You know, sure, it'd be good to win another race and so on, but that's not my main aim. My main aim is just to win, and, you know, sure, I've won the championship, but I still just, when I put the helmet on, I don't want anyone else to beat me, you know, so we're working as hard as we can, especially today, to try and get the bike working as best as we can for the race, and if everything remains the same, hopefully we should have a good race.
Forecast says rain.
Looks like it's not going to be the same.
Michael Doohan, how you doing? Nice to have your company right around Australia. Well, I mean, the rain pulled him back a little bit, but this is the last time that we'll be sitting here this year. And, of course, you've just heard from the 1994 world champion, and the fact that he's Australian makes us feel pretty well. Well, tonight we have the Europa Grand Prix. That's out of Spain. And then we have the Alfred Dunhill Cup. That's the golf from St Andrews, the home of golf. So, as we always say, the big sports just keep on coming here on Channel 9. Well, Barry Sheene, nice to have your company for the last time this season. It's a bit sad, isn't it? The season's come to an end. It's come to an end a good way with Michael Doohan winning the championship. But you have got the hottest scoop in town.
Well, I'm sure it is the hottest scoop. I found out that Darrell Beattie is definitely going to ride for Suzuki next year alongside Kevin Schwantz. And they're talking about running a three-man team, but as far as I'm concerned, Barros is definitely out, and it will be Darrell Beattie. And Abbey's going to ride for the Roberts team, and they're tossing up between Cadalora. They want Chandler, but Marlborough want Cadalora. But Beattie is definitely on a good motorbike.
So are you happy about that? Do you think that's the movie he had to make?
Oh, absolutely. You know, as far as I was concerned, Darrell's personality and the Roberts team would just mix like oil and water. You know, apart from the motorbike, you know, I'm really pleased he's going to Suzuki. I think it should be great.
Well, there you have it. You know, it's terrific. Darrell Beattie's had a bitch of a year as far as it goes with Yamaha. Of course, that horrible accident where he lost five of his toes, and he's come back pretty well with that, but then the bike's continually broken down. He's been pretty... Well, he's been pleased with his own performances since he came back from injury, but the bike's just let him down. So a change of team from Honda to Yamaha back to Suzuki. Let's get down to today's race. I mean, if it does rain, that'll really throw the cat amongst the pigeons. But Mick's obviously pretty confident that he can go out in the winning note.
How many times do you reckon he said win in that interview?
Yeah, exactly.
Obviously, once I spoke to him this morning, and he said that they got the bike sorted out a lot better now than it was. They're running a special new kind of water injection, and that's what's taken all the time to sort out. But sure, you know, if he can win, he will.
Good circuit, this, isn't it? I mean, great. There's lots of runoff areas. It's a pretty quick place, and they love their motorcycle racing, and generally the coverage is pretty good.
Well, it's true. It's good coverage. The circuit is really excellent. It was purpose-built for motorbikes, and everybody knows the circuit because they do the ERTA test there at the beginning of the year, and I haven't heard anybody that says they don't like it.
OK, so there you have it from Barry Sheene. Everybody's looking pretty much forward to the fact that if Mick Doohan could go out on a winning note. Let's have a look at how they'll line up on the grid, Bass.
Well, there you go. Luca Cadalora from Mick Doohan, John Kocinski, Alberto Pooch. Second row of the grid, Alex Creville, Darrell Beattie, Ito and Chandler. Third row of the grid, Alex Barros, John Reynolds, Sean Emmett on Schwantz's Suzuki again, and Niall McKenzie. Now, it's interesting you see there that's the third row for Sean Emmett. That's the second time he's ridden the bike. In reality, he's no further up on a factory bike than he was on the old Nail that he was riding.
That is interesting, isn't it?
Well, it is. You know, yes, it was excusable when he rode the bike for the first time, but he should be up there doing the business now. He should be in the first six.
OK, we'll take a break, come back with all of the action of the final 500cc Grand Prix for the season. Of course, the 250s follow, so you stay with us. Welcome back. Nice to have your company. We'll be watching us all around Australia. The final 500cc Grand Prix for the season. Coming out of Spain, and Barry, Cadalora on pole. He really has turned the wick up in the last few events this season.
Well, that's the funny thing. You know, he turned the wick up in Italy in front of the home crowd and had a good result. But the thing that's really I reckon tonight is the fact that Cadalora has been running, he's on Dunlops, and Dunlops do run qualifying tyres, whereas the Michelin people don't. So it's going to be really interesting to see if Cadalora can sustain that pace through the whole race. I personally don't think he can.
Looking out through Darrell Beattie's camera, 25 laps of this track, 4.747 kilometres around the race distance, 118.675 kilometres. This is the Europa 500cc Grand Prix, so we'll get some shots from Darrell Beattie. Last time on a Yamaha. Our information is he'll be riding Suzuki. Just as before you go, if Kocinski finishes in the top three, he will take second place from Kevin Swantz.
Oh, that's interesting, because I was under the impression that Schwantz couldn't be beaten, and in actual fact have said it, so wrong yet again.
So
mind.
That does put a lot of interest back in it. There's from Pooch's bike, just so you can see him there warming up the tyres.
It's going to be interesting to see Pooch and Creville, obviously both Spaniards, in front of their home crowd tonight, last race of the year. So we could see a few fireworks between Pooch and Creville. You see, Beattie has qualified back there in sixth place, and he was saying in his press release thing that he can't get a tyre to hang together for longer than about 12 laps. So I can't imagine that Cadalora, I'm sure he would have the same tyres as available as Beattie.
Well, here we go, the last race of the year. Don't forget, a lot more motorsport coming your way. We'll be going to Phillip Island shortly this month, in fact, to cover the superbikes. We've still got some Formula One Grand Prix. Adelaide's coming away. You'll see it all here on Nine. But here we go, the last 500cc race of the year. Can Mick Doohan go out the winning note? Can Kocinski maybe knock off Swantz for second place in the championship racing now? Kocinski got away well. Cadalora off the line. Pooch is a flyer as well. Down to the first corner, I think Kocinski. No.
Yeah, Mick's, well, yeah, looks Pooch and Kocinski. But I was just interested to see Doohan's thing. Didn't seem to want to come off the line then. It's, I don't know whether it has any problems or anything. Just keep a good eye on Doohan's bike for the first sort of half a lap, because it certainly didn't take off the line. You know, it just sort of started and then didn't go after that.
Everybody through the first corner, Kocinski and Pooch neck and neck as they go in. Pooch takes the lead now. Gee's been good this year, hasn't he?
Oh, it's great. You know, it'd be lovely to see if anybody else but Mick wins it. I'd love to see Pooch win it, because he's been
listen
brilliant.
To the crowd. Listen to the crowd as he leads. They've gone absolutely berserk.
He's been brilliant. His first year on 500, and I think he's done fantastically well, and it'd be great for him to get a win.
Kocinski in second place. The Honda's in behind him, I think. Or is it Cadalora? Hard to tell from the high shot. Now we can see properly.
Yeah, that's Ito there in third place.
Who's out in front? Wow. They will love this as long as he stays there.
I just hope I'm wrong about the look of Mick's bike coming off the line, because it just didn't look like the thing was going. It's everybody else was going forward and he was going backwards.
Well, he's certainly not pressuring as he has been, but let's have a think of his tactics of late too, because he's been absolutely starting a little slower, letting the tyres heat up and then coming through. But I know what you're saying, Ito in front of him, and that's unusual.
But it just didn't look like a, you know, you don't start slow in a straight bit. Yeah. You go as fast as you can on the straight bits. And that just, to me, didn't look like the bike was doing the business. You know,
running fourth at the moment. No, yeah, that's Cadalora fourth. No, he's back
six,
further.
Yeah. Right, now watch down the straight here. You see, it's Barros is in front of him there. And see if he gets Barros.
Here
yes,
he
does. Not quite.
No, not quite.
It's going to be interesting, because if he's still in that position on the next lap, I would say there's definitely something wrong with the bike.
So Pooch leading Kocinski, and this crowd just lapping every lap of this up, every second of it. Looks like we might have a real nail biter tonight. Ito all over the back now of Kocinski. Cadalora in behind him. Now here's the start, Baz.
You see Doohan in the middle there.
Yeah, backwards.
You see he's going backwards. They're going away from him, away from him. Still pulling away from him. Still pulling away. He's going backwards. Still going backwards. Still going backwards. Barros going past him. Everybody in their auntie going past him, basically. Look,
yeah.
You see, and that's flat out. You know, there's you're not holding back at all. So that doesn't
look good.
Doesn't look good to me.
Okay, Pooch still out in front. Kocinski chasing him. Then Ito up in third place, his best position for a while. Cadalora, Barros, and Mick's way back in behind Barros, or is it Cadalora? Cadalora goes through.
No, it's Barros.
Barros is there.
Now, you see, Honda are running a special water injection thing tonight. I don't want to get all complicated for those that don't understand. But basically, they've brought it out for this race. And knowing Japanese factories pretty well, I wouldn't be at all surprised if they've said, OK, Mick, well, you've got a race with this thing on, whether it's any good or not. And judging by the performance of his bike, I would almost guarantee that that he's got the super-duper boogie-woogie water injection that ain't going.
Does it work? OK, looking back from Kuchin to Ito there. That's Ito. So he's past Kocinski. He sits in second place. Kocinski back in third. Remember, if Kocinski finishes in the top three, he will take second place from Kevin Swantz, the 93 champ. So Kocinski with a fair bit to ride for.
Well, he has, yeah, and there's still talk that if Kocinski stays at Cagiva, then Cagiva will race next year, but I don't believe that personally. I think, as we said, I said whatever 3 months ago, that Cagiva will retire next year. So I hope I'm wrong.
So Mick still struggling back in the pack. That's Poos, there's Ito, Kocinski. He's back in fifth spot, so he's made up a couple.
Yeah, but he ain't making any ground at the moment, you see, and that is... You see there, he's behind Cadalora. He's got a shot of Barros. He's got some Greville behind him.
Ito has a look out around Poos, just puts the wheel out now, goes round the outside.
Whoa,
long way around there.
Long way, scenic route.
Kocinski tried to take advantage of that. Up on the inside line, closes right up behind him now, but still Poos out in front. And this crowd just loving every second of this.
It's so nice when somebody from the country where the Grand Prix is leads or wins the race, like Mick in Australia.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just so good for the sport.
Well, I still have wonderful memories of a grandstand just standing and applauding every time he came past last time round. It was just wonderful stuff.
That's it. That's Sito Pons there, the guy, that chap there. He's the ex-250 world champion. So Ito having a bit of a go at...
And Poos still in front. Now it's Cadalora in third place. Kocinski's dropped back slightly. Cadalora's passed. Look at Ito around the
boil.
Outside. Jeez, I tell you what, the Japanese rollers are fired up tonight, Baz, aren't they?
They are. You say, oh, dear me. No, back on the brakes again.
Wonderful shots here. Beautiful stuff.
That is really hot stuff. Oh, look at that. You see, that's where Ito was just got a bit excited there and ran in a bit deep and ran a bit wide. You see, Cadalora... Now past Kocinski, and it'd be very interesting to see how well the Dunlop tyres hang together.
We've talked before of Poos's problems with his arms. He will be having an operation after this race in the off-season. But so far he's going all right, but half distance he usually gets very tired.
Well, yeah, that's it. But if there is anything that is a good painkiller, it's your own Grand Prix. And... I'd love to see him win it. You know, if Mick can't, I'd love to see Pooch win it.
So you can see Mick in behind there in one, two, three, four, fifth spot still. But he really isn't making any ground. That's him there rounding up in behind. Is it Kocinski?
You see, yes, it is. If Mick is still this kind of distance from Pooch after another four or five laps, it doesn't look... that as bad as I originally thought, because that's Pooch plus 0.2 of a second on Ito. But as far as I can see, you see there, Doohan struggling to get out of the slipstream. Yes, he does.
Ito.
He gets past Kocinski.
Oh, no, he doesn't. Pooch just closes the door firmly on him. Ito's had a couple of goes, but Pooch has just closed him straight off. That's Cadalora back in the third place. So they're just easing fractioning away. I know it sounds silly, but they are just getting a little bit of a break. There they are there, one, two, and three.
I'd just like to see a shot from up in the air going down the front straight, just to see the speed of Doohan's bike relative to the four guys in front of him or three guys in front of him.
So he's up in the fourth spot, working his way through the pack, up in the fourth, in behind Cadalora now. Now, Barry, you might get an idea of some speed here.
That sort of acceleration stuff. I was more interested in the top speed, Cadalora catching up a bit. Right, now that's on. Now we'll see at the end of the straight. You see the distance Doohan is behind Cadalora. Let's see at the end of the straight when they get onto the front straight. He's got Cadalora, not quite. Right, now this will give you a good idea. You see that distance? Oh, Cadalora, smooth move past Ito.
Doohan right in behind Ito now. Here we go.
It's looking a lot better now than it was two laps ago.
Kocinski in behind Doohan. Tucked down. Here we go. Ito, the fastest man on the circuit at the moment.
All right, Doohan struggling in the... Will he get him?
No.
No.
Well, that's there, the two Hondas side by side, then.
There's definitely some kind of problem off the start, and your guess is as good as mine. Because now he seems like he's back on the pace again.
Darrell Beattie back in eighth spot at the moment. Darrell Beattie in eighth, 6 of 25. And Doohan riding as hard as he can, but Pooch, wow, what a job he's done so far. Cadalora sits in behind him. Then it's Ito back in third. There's the gap. Well, we can see that. We don't really need to read it, do we? Ooh, good speed shot. Gives you an idea there. Cadalora has a little look.
Yeah, the hills, really, because you couldn't see.
And this thing of Pooch has got some mumbo, I'll tell you.
Yeah, well, factory Honda. Just have a listen.
Okay, so as they make their way down around this track in Spain, you see Cadalora come right up behind him, take a break, come back shortly. Stay with us wherever you are in Australia. Seven of 25 gone. It's Pooch, Cadalora, Doohan, Ito, Kocinski, Creville now up into the top running spot.
That's Emmett, just the English guy that's parked the Suzuki in the bushes.
Bad luck for him.
Well, as far as falling off is concerned, I don't know. You know, you don't know what happened. But as I said earlier, yes, Doohan having a look at Cadalora.
So
well, it's looking much better for Mick now. You know, what your guess is as good as mine, what was going on at the beginning. But I'd be interested to see when Doohan gets with Pooch to see how, see if there's a difference in the speed of the Hondas.
Emmett was back in ninth spot when he dropped the bike. So Mick Dow makes a charge around the outside, gets a bit squeezed there too. He's got to use all of the track and then some back onto the main straight. Now
you'll get a good idea. You see... if Doohan gets past Cadalora. And Cadalora in the slipstream of Pooch. Does he do it? No, he doesn't.
Well, Pooch still leads a listen to the crowd, so Doohan certainly hasn't got the legs.
No, it definitely isn't going as quick as it normally does.
Bad choice of words, that actually, wasn't it?
But,
I said it was a bad choice of words.
What was it? I said
Mick Doohan certainly hasn't got the legs.
Oh dear.
Well, they're all right now. They work pretty good.
Well, they certainly work good enough, don't they? Look at Doohan round the out, not quite round the outside of Cadalora.
Pooch, this crowd will just go berserk if he can stay there. Cadalora's put plenty of pressure on him so far, though. Look, it's nice and close.
Kocinski coming up now.
Yep. All up, wheels up, and a bit of wobble there from everybody. They're all trying pretty hard.
Oh, Cadalora got a better line there. Oh, nice. Fastest lap, Kocinski.
Doohan now. Doohan, poor, again, just gets chopped. Fantastic ride from Pooch, no doubt about that. He's inspired.
Yeah, it just doesn't... The Honda doesn't accelerate, or Doohan's Honda doesn't accelerate anything like it normally does, or isn't accelerating as like it normally does. You see, now you watch the rear shot. See, Cadalora runs right up on Pooch. Pooch gets on the gas. Now watch. Watch. See, pulls out hand over fist on Cadalora. Cadalora comes up again on the brakes. Yeah, it doesn't look as bad as it did to start with, because Doohan is still there. And stamina-wise, Doohan can fight with the best of them stamina-wise, probably better than most.
Kocinski, though, putting plenty of pressure on Mick Doohan now. He's back and forth on the Cagiva. Pooch out in front, then Cadalora, then Mick, then Kocinski. This is one of the closest races we've had for a while.
Great.
Fantastic stuff. Crowd wheeling Pooch on bike 17. Now Cadalora again has another look. He can't do it, though. Gets pretty close this time round. On the outside now, can he tuck back inside? I don't think so. Trying hard. But he's got to go around the long way again.
I'm just being quiet and watching the distance between Cadalora and Doohan's power-wise. See the back end of Pucci's bike just starting to spin a little bit on the rear end. See Doohan closing up now, definitely on the gas now. Whoa, get him up the inside.
He just can't get past. He's had a look a few times.
No, I don't think, as it looks at the
Cadalora
moment, he does.
Around the outside. Wow. Great shots here. Look at Mick
really
Doohan
good,
there.
Isn't it? See, Cadalora's past Pooch.
These are some of the best onboard shots I've seen.
Really good, isn't it?
Fabulous shots. So, Pooch has lost the lead. Cadalora's gone there while we're looking at those close-up shots of Mick Doohan. Cadalora's got past Pooch. He's done a great job to hold on so far.
Now watch down the straight here. You see, Doohan, he's not in... can't get in the slipstream of Pooch. Right. But he's not going to get him on the brakes. No. Preville. Oh, close stuff.
Look at
Cadalora
this.
Cadalora around the outside.
That's a big move, wasn't it? I mean, Pooch must have said, how did you do that? Big move.
That really is a case of your life in their hands, because if you go around the outside of anybody, you know, really, it's all down to them. If they hang it out sideways, they take you with them.
Petey in seventh place, that's good news. His teammate Cadalora leads, then Pooch, then Doohan. Doohan keeping a really tight line here.
Doohan, if he gets, you've got a wide run into that, you know, run right up on Pooch now.
Cadalora taking advantage now, just building a slight gap.
Doohan got him. Doohan up in the second.
So Doohan now second chasing Cadalora. Down in horsepower we feel tonight, but certainly handling okay.
Now it'll be really interesting if Pooch can stay close to Doohan until they get to the main straight. Then I'll be really interested to see what the score is at the end of the straight. Oh, Kocinski. Yes, he got him.
So maybe that's that problem that he's got with his arms drop. He just gets so tired. I don't know. He seemed to be fighting so hard, and all of a sudden he goes back. Here's Mick going underneath him. But it makes you wonder, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, it does. You know, he owns up to it. He says, look, I can go quick for a third of the race, and then my arms are knackered, and there's nothing I can do about it.
What a shame. So here's the straight.
Yeah, trouble is, Pooch is so far back now that we get to... In actual fact, Pooch... Is that somebody just trying to get past Preville, I think, trying to get past Kocinski? Did he get in? Yes, he did. Preville's past Kocinski now.
Remember, Kocinski had to finish
in the
top three to knock off Kevin Spence for second place in the championship. So he's well back out of that at the moment. Now Doohan closing in on Cadalora. Then it's Preville in third place. He's had a big ride because he's come from a long way back to get into third spot.
Well, you see, on home territory, he has got to beat Pooch, whatever happens. You know, it's the best incentive, as I always say. It's
Doohan really trying to see the wheel come up. Lovely line through there. Beatty in seventh place still.
So the Yamaha looks really good tonight. Nice and it looks nice and steady. It's obviously handling all right. So far in, so far so good tire-wise. Don't see Cadalora having any problems.
So Kocinski fighting back with Creville. That's them. Now the gap's starting to narrow between Mick Doohan and Cadalora.
Oh, back end of Creville's bike there, just hanging out a little.
Some good dices here tonight, isn't there?
Yeah, it's great. It's close.
Kocinski, he'll fight all every inch of the way, no doubt about that. Creville, well, we know how quick he can be.
I think you're going to see a lot of this.
I think we might. Here we are, back at the leading two again, and it's Doohan still in behind Cadalora. A little bit closer now, though.
Yeah, but you can see what I mean about the speed. It definitely, definitely ain't going like it normally does.
Good battle tonight. Interesting battle, isn't it? Now it comes down to a few mind games now.
Well, you see, as far as Cadalora is concerned, Cadalora is prepared to put more on the line tonight than Doohan would be, because for Cadalora to get another win, it just endorses in some people that are anti-Cadalora's mind that they should have Cadalora next year as against Chandler. Creville, gotcha.
So as this race really becomes very interesting with little dices all over the place, the mind games will continue. We'll continue our coverage. Stay with us, Australia, back shortly. Ha! 13 of 25, a ding-dong battle going on between Cadalora, Doohan, Creville, Kocinski, Puig and Ito. Ito dropping way back. He was in second place at one stage. Puig, of course, was leading. So those two have dropped back through the pack. The interest here, Doohan's just lost a little bit of ground here to Cadalora. Now he seems to close it up, but I get the feeling that Cadalora can open up the gap whenever he wants to.
Well, I think you'll find that Mick is just sort of having a bit of a rest and just going to sort of conserve himself a bit and then put the pressure on when we get a few more laps down, because he doesn't have the sort of power that he normally does, as far as I can see anyway. And you know, the sensible, he's ridden hard to get where he is, so the logical thing to do would be to have a bit of a rest and then have a good go and get past Cadalora and pull out some ground. But as I say, Cadalora is the man that really has the most to gain by winning tonight.
Back on this big long straight again, coming down under the bridges. There's Doohan, different line. Pooch back out, the man we said that was leading for so long, and Ito. There's the readout. Beatty still sits in, just in behind Pooch. We'll get a shot of him shortly.
Are
still
you sure?
Seventh. Well, hopefully. He's in seventh place. And there he is, just a flash. So he's not that far back behind Pooch at the moment. That's the gap from Creville Kocinski. Now there's Pooch. Where's Darrell?
Oh, there's
Darrell
Beatty.
There's Darrell Beatty. He's closing in on him.
Oh, it'd be so good for Darrell to get a good ride.
Well, know. I mean, the damn thing hasn't finished round after round. Somebody off there.
Drop the pot there.
44.
That's Mark Garcia, French guy.
So he's hit the dirt and pulled up. As we said, there's a lot of runoff area on this circuit. It's really good. From these high shots, you get to see it all, and gee, it does the job, doesn't it? They go off, bang, pull straight up.
It's great. It's when there's a circuit that is purpose-built for motorcycle racing. It was so long, the sort of correlation of Formula One, and you'd have to race on circuits that were basically designed and made for Formula One cars, and it was terrible, you know. But now, you know, in Spain, for example, they get a lot more people at the bike races than they do for the Formula One. So it's good, you know, they build tracks specifically for bikes.
Well, I've got to say it. I mean, we've spent so much money on Eastern Creek, but gee whiz, why didn't they go and have a look at a place like this first?
Yeah, I can agree with you on that.
Upsets a lot of people, but it's a fact of life. I mean, there's so many walls now at Eastern Creek. They could have had a circuit like this. Let's face it, they started from scratch. Anyway, starting from scratch is Cadalora, because he's out in front, right in behind him. Michael Doohan from Australia, the world champ. Greville, Kocinski, Ido, Pooj, Beattie still in behind him. This has been a real good street fight, these two. Greville and Kocinski.
Yeah, when you see Kocinski on change of direction, lift the front wheel up, excuse me, it seems he gets to a certain stage of the race and then seems to really get interested in it. And that is one of the first signs you see that Kocinski is enjoying himself, that he gets the thing on the back wheel. And then he seems to go quicker after that, so we'll have to wait and see.
He's got a bit to ride for too, John Kocinski. If you've just joined us, he needs to finish in the top three. That way he can take Kevin Swanson's place as number two in this year's championship. So there is a bit to ride for. And, of course, the question up in the air whether Cagiva will continue. Barry said months ago that he felt that they were going to concentrate on the superbikes from next year on, but as yet no official announcement has been made. Cadalora now building again, Barry. Seems to be able to build it, doesn't he?
Well, he does. He builds a bit of a lead and then Mick catches it back up again, you know, but you can only do that for so long. If you're... it'd be great to know. It'd be great to have a two-way saying, right, what's going on, Mick? What's the problem? You know, what's happening? Because it's all assumption. And by the look of the gap that Cadalora's got now on Doohan...
Kocinski passed Preville, sorry. Yeah.
It just looks by the gap that Cadalora had the last time we saw it that it's now not looking good again for Doohan.
What a battle this has been. Preville comes back at Kocinski again.
Dear me.
It's a real scrap, this.
Oh, lock her up. Look at that. Nice. Good bit of braking there by Kocinski.
So this is where the action is at the moment. They have been hard at it since the word go. Look at this. Terrific stuff here. Evenly matched fight, this one.
Oh, really? And, you know, with so much at stake for Kocinski and so much at stake for Creville, you know, because for Creville to watch... Now, watch Kocinski on the brakes. See him there changing down the gears. Locking her up. Just a little bit of a wiggle. Nice, good move. Yeah, it's going to be interesting if this goes right down to the... wire, as they say, it should be quite a fight. But if it does go down to the wire, my money would definitely be on Kocinski.
I hope I'm wrong and that's just a dirty camera lens, but I saw a couple of spots on that lens. Maybe just a couple of little bugs that have been pushed there, but I noticed a couple of spots on it.
If it does start to rain, that is the worst possible thing you can ever ask for. When you get halfway through a race and it starts to rain, the good thing is now with the regulations, they red flag it and make it into two races.
Well, of course, it was predicted it was going to rain throughout the 500 race, but I get the feeling that Mick's decided second place is the go.
Well, you look at the gap there, it's quite a big lump.
He certainly dropped back by at least a second and a bit. Real big charge from up around eighth place to get into second place. It was all over the back of Cadalora just two or three laps ago, but certainly he's dropped back now.
See, the problem is, Dazza, if the engine isn't going the way that it should do... Oh, Kocinski's
back and forth again.
Yeah, he's done it again. Good move.
Correctly, back in third again.
You see, if the engine isn't going as well as it should do, or it normally does, then you have to tear the tyres apart. You have to push everything, yourself included, much harder than you would normally do it. And if you're tearing the tyres apart, if you're rushing into corners, you know, with the front locked up and squirting it out with the back hanging out, you just tear the tyres to pieces. But that's the only way you can get up there. So it's like a catch-22. You either save all your tyres and finish a graceful fifth or something, or you go out and have a real good go and finish a distant second.
This is the scrap of the race, no doubt about that. Kocinski wants that third spot. There's that dirty lens I talked about. The spots are still there, so I don't think it is running. That's the gap back to Cadalora to Pooj. Remember, he was leading for the first half dozen laps, now 12 and a half seconds in behind Cadalora. That's water. I was right. That's water.
Right.
It is starting to rain. I thought so. So now this will be interesting.
So the old peepers are all right then, Dazza?
Working okay.
The windows are working all right.
The windows are all right. I thought I noticed a drop of rain and correct. So let's hope it doesn't get any heavier. At the moment, the rider, you'll notice as soon as the rider feels it's too dangerous, one will just throw his hand up.
Yeah, you see what happens when you get a little bit of spotting of rain like that, you go just as hard for a couple of laps until you can actually start to see the rain on the circuit, which the tyres are still warm, they're still gripping, and it's a bit of a, you really have to push yourself, you really have to convince yourself it's still all right, and you just push it until the thing starts to slide around. It's a horrible situation to be in.
So Cadalora now still leading Mick Doohan. Rain just mistily falling down. It's really got some great ingredients. This race, stay with us, take a break, back to them. Eight of 25 laps, it's Cadalora doing Kocinski in that third spot. He must finish to take away second place from Kevin Swantz, Creville, Ito, Pooj. That's how they run, the top runners for you. The rain hasn't increased. We had those few drops you could see on from the onboard camera, but certainly no more. Look at this.
Oh,
foot off the peg.
You see, that's Kocinski, was just going right over to the white line to stop Creville slipstreaming him. And then came back, and there was Creville.
Wow, nearly a touch there, and the foot came off the peg. Been a great, real battle between these two.
Yeah, Kocinski won't throw in the towel. You know, he's quite a hard fighter. And you never know, Dazza. You see, it could just swing the pendulum so that if Cagiva finished second in the World Championship, sensational achievement, and you never know.
Let me bounce this off you. If Kocinski finishes in fourth, he'll be equal with Swantz on 169 points.
But how many, who's got the most wins? Schwantz has got two wins, so that means Schwantz will take it.
Yeah, so Kocinski must finish third, that right? Tell you what, we've got the best mathematical brains all working here, let me tell you.
Right,
OK, we're going to have, there's that rain, it hasn't got any worse. We're going to have a replay of that that manoeuvre on the straight.
Right, now you see Kocinski swinging out. Whoa! And what he was doing, he was trying not so that Creville didn't get his slipstream, and then in your sort of peripheral vision, you just swing back, and you suddenly think, oh my dear, you know, you can, it does happen. You
can, that speed, yeah.
You know, it's, I've seen some nasty things happen when people are banged into one another.
All right, now that's Pooj. Darrell Beattie's behind Pooj.
Yeah, Darrell's right there. Go,
so
Dazza.
So he's closing up on Pooj. So he's riding pretty well, Darrell Beattie. At least the bike's still going. That's a change.
Well, it's good. You know, the bike's going, and obviously the tyres are hanging together pretty well at the moment. Right, Cadalora stuck behind.
In the traffic.
That's it. Hengeli, Bernard Hengeli.
Barros in behind Beattie. So Cadalora through the traffic. Now we'll get the gap back to Mick.
Doesn't look like Cadalora's having any tyre problems at the moment. Anyway, it's certainly not on the rear end. On the front end, it's difficult to see if people are having problems. But it's this far into the race, 20 out of 25. So normally, if the tyres were going to take a dump, they will have done it by now.
Well, five to go. I sort of get the feeling that Mick can't close the gap from there. The director must think the same way because he's back here looking at this scrap here, which is, of course, Ito, Pooj and Darrell Beattie. So it's nice to see Darrell Beattie for a change. We haven't seen much of him all year.
Dear me, squirting it. That's just really hard acceleration between the two corners, and she stepped out on him.
Really good step out. So Beattie now still closing in on Pooj. Ito in front. Barros in behind.
Yeah, I was going to say, and Barros has woken up, hasn't he, all of a sudden?
Look at this.
Apparently, Barros was saying that he wanted to do the same kind of thing as Senna, in that he didn't want to test during the winter and he wanted just to turn up, you know, like a month before the first race and ride. Well, you can do that if you're taking the World Champions Trophy home each year, but you can't do that when you're wobbling around, you know, in sixth, seventh and eighth place.
Back with Mick Doohan in second place. And doesn't look like catching Cadalora at this stage. And he's down to the traffic as well.
Yeah, ooh, wide one. That's
good our riding mate. Now, let him go.
That's our mate Dirakos.
Yeah, let him go. Good riding that time. Yeah, Catalora's done a bowler now. No doubt about that. Big gap back now, 3.5 seconds.
Yeah, no chance.
So Mick may have settled for second. Maybe that little hint of rain is a lot of things to take into consideration here. I'd like to have a look at Beattie again.
When you get the really slippery conditions, and especially at the last race where basically you've got nothing to gain and everything to lose, you want to spend the winter in happiness and not in hospital.
Exactly. Ah, oh, Beattie.
Go, Dazza.
So he's picked up one.
Yeah.
Beattie on the charge past Poozley. Look at the distance he's got on Poozley. Went past. Back at a sixth spot now. So he's in the top six. Chasing Ito. This is from Poozley's bike.
Now you get a really good idea of the difference of the speed between the Yamaha and the Honda here.
Watch this.
Up the inside.
Oh, what a shot. Just loomed there, didn't he? Oh, terrific stuff.
Dazzle jumped then, didn't he?
Oh, that was great. I think the onboard stuff's been fantastic.
It's really,
tonight.
Very good.
Really good stuff.
Oh,
okay, now this
Greville
scrap still
in.
Goes on. So, Kocinski's got to get past Greville. That's the interest now. Got to get past Greville. He's got to get into third spot if he can. He would know that he's only got a couple of laps to do it now. He's passed him here twice, not close enough this time round.
So Kocinski will put everything into it. You know, well, not that Greville won't, but you'd have to.
It's been an even scrap, though, hasn't it?
Oh, absolutely. You know, if you're a gambling man, you definitely go for Kocinski. Well, I would anyway.
So back he comes again. Remember, if he takes third spot, he knocks Swans out of the second spot in the championship. That's his incentive.
He's trying, Kocinski. You see the back end of the Cagiva there, spinning and gripping. Go, Dazza, up the inside of Barros.
So, Darrell Beattie still doing okay.
Now, you see, Barros obviously knows that Beattie's been asked to... Whoa! That's just winding her up and of braking and gaining and breaking traction.
They are brave. Lost a bit of ground now, though. He's going to fight back. Hasn't been a wonderful ding-dong battle.
Now
watch this.
That's good. You know, the bike handles well under those conditions. You saw there, it didn't really... Normally, when you get a situation like that, it transfers all the aggravation to the front. It's Darrell up the inside of Ito.
Yeah, and Barros has gone through, too. So Barros has decided he's going to go with Darrell Beattie. So Darrell Beattie on the charge. This has been a terrific race from him tonight, and at least we've seen a bit of him tonight.
But isn't it amazing how it takes something like this to wake Barros up?
Yeah, exactly.
Ridiculous. Oh, that's done Dazza a bit of a favour.
Yeah, bit of traffic there. Let's him go. Watch the speed here. Ooh, Barros had a good look at him too. This is Cadalora out in front. He's going to go on a win it, no doubt about that. Well, I don't want to put the mock on him, but he's got a good enough lead that he could almost push it home from here. So Cadalora aboard the Roberts Yamaha. He's in first place. Mick Doohan on the Honda, second place. Big fight going on for third.
Yeah, it'd be really interesting to see the third place fight, wouldn't it? The lucky thing is, Dazza, it's Spain, so we're bound to see Greville.
Without question. But Cadalora, a nice race from here tonight. Gee whiz, he's ridden well toward the end of the season. Well, that's probably unfair. He's probably ridden well all through the season. He's just his
Everything,
bikes work
yeah,
very well.
Yeah, exactly that. The tyres and the bike are working well now.
Ah, Kocinski's got him.
There you go.
So Kocinski now in third spot. Greville chasing him. What a terrific fight this has been. Oh,
he's trying hard. Kocinski is really trying hard.
So he wants to finish on the podium. Greville wants to spoil that for him. He's come back from a distance too a couple of times.
Oh, look at that now. What are that for a smooth move? That is a brilliant about breaking.
Yeah, congratulations to the Spaniards too. They're showing us the replays of the passing moves. Good coverage this one. Terrific.
Oh, Kocinski, bit of a break around the back end there.
Must be pretty frightening for Cavill. He's sitting there watching all this.
It's not that bad if you're not really right up his backside and it happens, you panic a bit. But if you're sort of 20 or 30 feet back, it's nothing really. You know, you just think, oh, great, he's having tyre trouble. Greville was right up alongside him and Kocinski outbraked him.
Two laps to go. Can he hang on? Because, I mean, they've passed each other a half a dozen times, these two.
I really hope so for Cagiva. I really hope he hangs on.
24-25, the leaders are on now.
Now, you see what Kocinski doesn't want to have. He's trying so hard that one sideways and you've lost it. You know, you lose that vital 50 metres and it's the end of the story.
Gavilli's just got a length or two on him there out of there. Gee whiz, look at that. He's opened up a good gap. This is back to Cadalora up front. So Cadalora, congratulations to him tonight. It's been a terrific ride from him. Doohan was all over him when he fought back from eighth spot, put a lot of pressure on him. But Cadalora just held his head together and really has ridden a very heady race. Kocinski seems to have Cavill's measure now.
Well, I wouldn't think
of it. Here he comes again.
Right now.
I'll back Kocinski.
At the end of the straight is where get through this lot.
Yeah, he's got enough on him. Mick Doohan in second place.
He's got enough on him, but we've got another lap after this, haven't we? So
here we go. If he can hold, see, he's holding that gap pretty well.
Right, now let's see at the end of the straight then. I wouldn't bank on it at the end of the straight, does I?
Greville charges up, we lose sight of them. Oh, no! I hate it when you do that to me.
Kocinski
gets back in front of the game.
Great. He deserves to beat Greville.
That's been a terrific even battle.
Oh, it's terrific, yeah, I agree. But look, Greville.
He hasn't given up yet. Kocinski hanging on with everything, and Greville gets a little lovely.
You can hear the Spanish commentators on his third pacemaker.
So Kocinski hanging on to Greville. This is vital for Kocinski.
Look at this.
Goes up the inside, can't get him. Kocinski hanging on. He's got
to
finish
third. Good run for Greville out of that. No,
Kocinski gets the run there. Look at the speed shot there. You get an idea of how quick they're going. Greville lunges up again, but Kocinski holds him at bay. What an incredible race this has been.
Yeah, really, that's been a good tussle, isn't it?
Well, Kocinski knows if he finishes in third, he gets second spot in the World Championship. Last time round for the 500s tonight. What a way to
go. Good race.
Oh, terrific. Here we go.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no, it's Ito down.
So Ito has crashed.
Out
there, Kocinski around there, and Greville.
That's it, Kocinski's got.
Oh, they've touched.
Right now, that was nobody's fault, really. Well, if there was any blame to apportion, then it would be Greville, because Greville pointed it.
Cadalora, let's come back to the leader, because he's going to win this in fine style. What a moment that was, and what a climax of the battle. But up goes the front wheel. Cadalora takes it. Not that far in front of Michael Doohan when you had a look at it. Here's Kocinski, wasn't far back in third. Greville, congratulations to those two. Oh, look at Greville. He belts the tank. Oh, boy, what a moment for him, though. Cadalora, well done. Terrific race from him. That's Ito they're working on there. Let's hope he's okay. It doesn't look good. They're building a stretcher underneath him.
Well, that's sad. Last lap of the last race.
Let's have a look at this. Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Yeah, well, he's up on his haunches there. He's
I would say it's just the leave me alone syndrome.
Yeah, I don't like it when they start fooling around those stretches. You start thinking of spinal damage or something like that. Anyway, that's the way he's moving. Cadalora takes the acknowledgement of the crowd. Up goes the wheel again. Doing in second place. Greville, they shake hands.
Actually, Mick was really close at the end of it.
Sure he was. And I'll tell you what, Kocinski closed on him. Darrell Beattie finished in fifth spot. Okay, so let's take a break as Cadalora does the boogie. We'll be back with a presentation. More to come. Don't forget the 250s yet, too.
All right, now this is the bit with Kocinski and Greville. Watch. Wallop, right. I tell you, he was so lucky, Greville, there. What happened? He just went into the corner, tried to get on the inside of Kocinski, and basically it just didn't work out, and he was very, very lucky not to go flat on his face.
He was too. Luca Cadalora carrying the Italian colours around. He's taken the race. And, Barry, what we've got to say is that we were so in raptures with the way Kocinski was going about this championship thing, we forgot about Cadalora. The fact that Cadalora has now beaten him puts him in a second place in the championship.
Exactly that, you know, because I thought, well, hang on a second. When I saw right at the end of it, I saw the results, and Kocinski was third. So, but it's still third's not as good as second, is it, really?
So Cadalora's got up. OK, well, we're talking about John Kocinski. Let's have a listen to what he said after the race. It was an action-packed one for him.
John Kocinski in third place. Just Alex Crivellet was piling on the pressure towards the end of that race, huh?
Well, yeah. I don't know how much really pressure he was putting on me. You know, we were pretty much getting away from him everywhere. It's just, you know, on the straight, my bike's just not competitive. It's pretty easy to see, and I gave everything I had, and it just didn't seem that Cagiva was as eager to be second as I was, and this is where we're at.
Hey, John, you always give your best, yeah?
Oh, well, we sure try. I know the last lap was pretty exciting. I know Alex crashed into the back of me and tore a hole in my seat, and, you know, it was pretty close there at the end, but, you know, we tried to hang on to it and, you know, still get on the podium.
Good to see you on the podium again. Congratulations.
Yeah, not the happiest fellow there. I mean, I know what you've been saying for a long time about Cagiva. I get the feeling that that's the case, and he knows that.
I would say absolutely that. You know, you're not going to turn around and say, well, I was keen to get second and Cagiva weren't. You know, Cagiva have done the best job they possibly can, and I think John's going to write a book on how to burn your bridges.
Well, he sort of does that. I think it's a bit unfair to say that the bike wasn't competitive, because in the last few races it's been more than competitive.
Well, exactly that. You know, it's an irony he didn't finish second, but... you know, it's not the best way to carry on. You know, he fell out with Suzuki, fell out with Roberts, and if, you know, the Cagiva brothers think the world of him, and to say that, they'll hear that after, and they'll be mortally wounded, and it's just a nail in his coffin, really.
Yeah, well, of course, the shame of it all is that the guy's a great character, and we don't want to lose that manufacturer. All right, let's go to the winner's podium now, where John Kocinski will take his place with Cadalora and Australia's Michael Doohan. There they go.
Yeah, I'm sure at the beginning of that thing, that was just this water injection thing they're playing around with. And, you know, the only way to test something new, really, if you could afford to do it, is in a race. And all they had to lose was really Mick winning the race. And it didn't really mean that much to Honda to win tonight. It's more important to test something against stiff competition.
Well, of course, Mick's finished with 9 wins for the year.
And he's finished upright in one piece and quite happy.
All right, let's recap the results as they make their way back down into the garages now. Luca Cadalora, of course, for Yamaha, 25 points for his win.
Yeah, second place, Aaron Mick. Third, Kocinski. Fourth, Greville. Fifth, good old Dazzle. And sixth, Alex Barros. Championship positions.
Really pleased for Darrell Beattie there.
Oh, absolutely. Michael Doohan, as we all know, is the winner. Luca Cadalora up into second. John Kocinski third. Kevin Schwantz down into fourth. Alberto Pooch beats Greville, and I'm sure he's very happy about that.
that was a great dice, wasn't it? Less than Manufacturers Championships.
Right, there you go. Honda won it from Suzuki, from Yamaha, Cagiva, and Rock Yamaha.
Now, just recapping, because perhaps viewers have just joined us, the big scoop that you had at the top of the show is the fact that Darrell Beattie will be riding for Suzuki next year, and you're pretty sure that's right?
I'm pretty sure it's right, and I spoke to Japan and told them I already knew about it from Italy, which I didn't, but it was just a punt, and they said, oh, yes, we're very happy. So, you know, it's great. Couldn't happen to someone nicer, and that goes for both sides.
So it goes from sort of Honda to Yamaha to Suzuki. A little bit of a gypsy is Darrell Beattie, but let's hope this move is the right one. Well, the 250cc championship this year has just been absolutely sensational. The races have been great. The riders' championship stands this way.
Yeah, and you see there, but the only guy that can beat Biaggi is Okada. Capros is third, Doriano Romboni, Ralph Wallman and Jean-Philippe Bourgier. So the interest is between Okada and Biaggi, and well, it's a good one.
Well, this is it. This is for the championship, this particular race. So Biaggi, Okada fighting it out. It's come right down to the last Grand Prix of the year. Let's recap for you now as we take you back with around about six or seven laps to go. A ripper race.
Just opened up a little bit of a buffer now. That means nothing, but it is a lot as far as this race has gone.
It's a lot when you're trying to catch it back.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It really has just opened up that enough space there for him to breathe, because Okada has got to contend with the pack behind him, and they're all over the back of him. Biaggi's got the quickest bike, so if he can maintain that gap, that makes life easier.
That really does. Phenomenal, the difference of the... I can't... The Aprilia hasn't been that good all the year. Don't think that Biaggi's had a bike that is that has been as superior as it is tonight, because that really isn't the story. Just listen to... This is Romboni. Just gives you a rough idea of how you're easing the throttle on and easing it off.
Fabulous stuff. Great coverage of this. And I don't think you could get a more graphic illustration of what it's like to race one of these 250cc machines and what you've just gone through there. Listening to the engine screaming, and look at Biaggi now. He's really got into it now.
And you see, the last thing Okada wants is Romboni to do this.
And he looks like he might do it this time, because there's no sign of Okada, yes. So Romboni's patience has really, and the pressure has paid off.
And you see, he learned by his mistakes, because the last time he slips through him, he went to the left of him, which for some reason or another is nearly always seems the natural way to go. But obviously, you see, the other time, he went to the other side of Okada, which doesn't give you the chance to do this, which is just stuff it up the inside.
He was beautifully balanced then, wasn't he? Just kept it upright before he turned in. Looked good.
That's a slipstream.
Yep.
When you get a slipstream on a bike, it's quite incredible. You're about 20 or 30 feet back, and then you can just start to feel it pulling. And then all of a sudden, it's like someone turning on a vacuum cleaner, and it just sucks you forward. And when you're the guy that is being slipstreamed, it's like someone turning on a vacuum cleaner pulling you backwards. It's quite a weird feeling. It almost feels like someone's got hold of the back of your levers. But you see the gap now that Biaggi's got, and it's going to take a lot of catching back.
Mind you, we have said this before.
We have, without any doubt, you know, but... and we've also said, I've said on at least four occasions, he must have learned his lesson by now.
Well, he's ridden very smart tonight. He's been passed twice for two very brave moves from Okada, but he knows he's got the speed, so he's picked his places to come back onto the straight. Now he can burn them off. And now Okada slips back just a couple of lengths in behind Romboni.
Yeah, you see, Romboni's done Biaggi the biggest favour in the world, because... for Okada to be able to get past and Harada's, if you can just hang it together until the end of the straight. No. Oh, there's someone else. Eskil Suter.
I think I'd just leave it there.
They don't grow when you plant them.
He's okay.
And see what happened here. Probably a front end. Absolutely. Front end lose, they call that.
Oop, and into the dirt, and that does the job it's designed to do. Pulls them up quick. Round the big loop. Look at Biaggi now. He is absolutely flying. Rombone still in second place. Okada, Harada, then Caparossi.
I've been watching Caparossi. I wouldn't mind betting that Caparossi's going to have a big go in the last few laps. Got six laps to run now, and he's close enough. And so you see there, he's suddenly turned the wick up, Caparossi.
Up in behind him.
I tell you what, if Okada can make up that distance, they ought to give him a knighthood. I don't know about a world championship.
He really has opened up a big gap, and of course he's still got to contend with Rombone.
Right, now there's your slipstream, and what else? And up the inside on the brakes. And you see there, Caparossi still just picking up the slipstream.
Wonderful stuff. Again, from the high shot.
You see, that guy's bike, all those three bikes are virtually identical speed-wise, and that is the difference that's getting a toe, as you call it, and Rombone coming back at Okada.
Yeah, so Rombone, that's what I'm saying about Okada. He really, he can't relax because Rombone's going to be all over the back of him, and now Caparossi, as you predicted.
Biaggi's done an absolute runner.
He's gone. This fight here is so intense that that's just helping Biaggi. Look at him.
I can just see, you remember, you know their team manager, Pernat, the guy that used to be the team manager for Cagiva. I can imagine him, what he's saying in the pits. Four laps to run, is he going to plant it?
Caparossi, a big mover too. There's Biaggi, there's Okada, Rombone. Caparossi, Harada's just dropped back that length or so now. He got in touch but hasn't been able to mix it too well. He just hasn't had the speed.
Caparossi's the danger man as far as those. You look at the. See what we've got here. Now you watch Caparossi. See if we can get him on the brakes. No, because.
Oh, yes. Up
whoa,
the inside.
How tight is that? Yo, look at Okada. Good. He's hot tonight. Yeah. I tell you, he really is riding well.
Pulling off some big moves around corners.
That was a really good move because he let everybody sort of settle for their places, their position, their sort of entry into the corner, and then stuck it in between the pair of them.
There's the gap back. So Biaggi's just got to keep it going. Here we go again. Quite sure well, that's about this one. That's different.
Now see, Caparossi. Yeah, there Caparossi. You go.
He's been the sleeper, now the mover. Biaggi, been the fastest and most spectacular of the 250cc riders right throughout the season. He's only got a few laps to go to become the world champion. I reckon all sorts of things will be going through his mind. He's a very emotional man, we know that.
At the German Grand Prix, Hockenheim, Rombone and Biaggi had a real coming together in the stadium on the last lap, and it really upset Rombone. He was not too pleased about it. And Biaggi said to Rombone, after Rombone said, look, listen, that is not playing the game. And he said, look, this is motorbike racing, not ballroom dancing.
It was a bit of push and shove.
Say that.
But no chance of that at the moment because he's built up a lead. He's had to fight for it. He's been knocked back in the pack a couple of times. Got the speed, no doubt about that, but he really has taken advantage of getting the break and building on it. Caparossi now in second place, but look at this, there's nothing in this. Okada back in fourth. Rombone challenges, I think he'll get him.
Yeah, got him.
Rombone's got him, so he goes back in a second. I tell you what, we've been giving everybody else raps. This bloke's ridden pretty well too.
Well, and a rap, and he ain't got a ride for next year. You know, it's a total irony. When you think of, like, Pier Francesco Chili, Helmut Bradl, Romboni, you know, they're standing, propping up the pit wall. It's ironic.
So Biaggi, just a few laps to go now. Will Romboni stay in second place? I'm not sure. They're all over each other, this lot. Okada, he's back into the fray again. Just drops back slightly, though. Caparossi up again in behind Romboni. Now, here comes Okada. Wow.
Yeah, really, for Okada, you see, if Biaggi falls off now, then Okada is not going to win the championship from that position.
Romboni, Caparossi, Okada, Harada. Second, third, fourth, and fifth, and there's the time from Biaggi back to Okada. Looking at Caparossi, back from Romboni's fight. Here's Biaggi.